Number 10, we have Cannon at Hansaback. So, yeah, it moved a bit that. Oh, no, just joking. Number 10 is Jules and Drag. Yeah, at Etherling. A dueling GCI. It's a. It's my favorite GCI that I've written. I prefer to Rudon, which is a really unpopular opinion. But the thing with this one is it is really aggressive compared to Rudon. I don't know if it has more airtime, quite at the same level, I think. But the layout is so aggressive, and it is just perfect for size. And yeah, it's a dueling coaster as well. It's a fun thing to do on a coaster. It has this crazy turn right here. This is feels crazy. It spanks to the right while it turns to the left. It is crazy. Okay, at number 9 I have Colossus at Heidi Park. So yeah, I would say my top 9 is so tight, compact, filled with world class coasters. Colossus is the first one of them. The drop is amazing, and the first two airtime hills just give some of the most crazy eject airtime that you can experience on a coaster, really. But the rest of the ride is just good, in my opinion. But if it continued like the first half, this coaster would be in my top 3 coasters that I've ridden for sure, if not number 1. Because that first section of this ride is crazy. This Helix is the only pointless part of the ride for me. It is just a bit rattly and rough, not enjoyable at all. But the rest of the ride is absolutely amazing. Especially the first section. It is open again 2019, by the way. It has been closed for 3 years now. Number 8, I have Goliath at Waterby Holland. So, this is a Intamin mega coaster, and it is a really good coaster. Amazing drop, and first airtime hill is great. And yeah, then it has a Stangle Dive, the first one to be built ever. I love the first section you have here. The middle section is kind of weak. It doesn't have that much many forces, so that's why Goliath is coming at number 8 instead of higher. It could be higher if it has some more intensity, but this coaster is not that intense at all, I would say that. But the first section is amazing, and the last section to come right here is amazing. The last 3 bunny hills is crazy. Really, really got some insane ejector airtime. And that last turn hit some really good G's as well. At number 7 I have Piraten. This is the coaster that I ride the most at the time. I have season pass to Dior Summerland, so yeah, I come there a lot, and this is a fantastic ride. Especially for its size. The drop is great. It feels way steeper than it is. This airtime hill is the weakest point of the ride. The rest of the ride is just non-stop action. This pulls amazing ejector airtime. And here comes my favorite section of the ride. This 3 back-to-back twisted airtime hill. You really get some true rattles on these hills. And you also get the ejector airtime. It might be a short ride, but it is just non-stop action from you leave the drop to you hit the brakes. Yep, I put Icon at number 6. I know this seem really, really, really high if you have not ridden Icon, but yeah, I know it looks a bit slow on the POV, but it rides faster than it looks. And it really have some really and amazing moments of the ride, and it is a really long ride as well. The first half here is great, but it's not the best part of the ride for me. Although I love the last section of the first half with this headline roll and these two twisted airtime hills. And yeah, you hit the tunnel and the second launch. This Immelmann gives some stunning hang time. Other than that, you have some whippy turns. You have a Helix right after this amazing Atom Hill. Here, this actually gives some really, really good G-forces. And it finished with a couple of Airtime Hills and some twists and turns. And that's the end of a fantastic, might not be that intense, but still a fantastic coaster. Number 5, I have Battle at Leesburg. A Intamin prefabricated wooden coaster. So yeah, Balder is a fantastic ride. It has a really steep first drop. I think it's 70 degrees or something. Feels really, really steep, especially in the back. Other than that, it is just a pure airtime machine. It doesn't have the best variation of elements, which is why it's only at number 5. Now I say only, but yeah, 5 is yeah incredibly high since I have ridden 118 coasters. But it is a world-class wooden coaster with some really, really good ejector airtime. I think Balder might be the best coaster I've ridden for airtime, and I am a big fan of airtime, so that's why I love Balder that much. The ending heals, these three heals, is really aggressive. I really loved Battler's ending. At number 4 we have a coaster that I rode recently, Nemesis at Alton Towers. So I've been excited for almost my whole life to ride this coaster, at least since I became a roller coaster enthusiast or roller coaster fan. So yeah, waited about 8 years to ride this, and I finally got to ride it, and man, it beated my expectations. It is crazy intense, the forces is out of this world. This COG roll is the whippiest inversion, the best inversion I've ever experienced. The loop is great too, not the strongest part of the ride at all for me. Also the Helix that it was in the beginning was absolutely incredible. This just has so many insane forces, this ride, and the terrain, just the overall experience about this ride is amazing. Alright, number 3 I have Shambhala at Porta Montuta. So yeah, this really did surprise me, because I was not really the biggest fan of Silverstar in Europark, but other B&M Hybrid I've ridden. Yes, I know Shambhala is another level, but still, it's made my top 3, that's pretty incredible. But the thing with Shambhala is, it has really, really, really good airtime on any, all of the hills it has. It feels really, really fast on the bottom of the first drop, and it is a graceful experience. And yeah, I really love airtime. I didn't know I loved floater airtime that much. But yeah, I found out I did when I rode this coaster, because it is almost all floater based. It has one ejector, other than that, just floater. And I absolutely love it. It's out of this world. Might be the best B&M hyper out there, but I can't tell that because I have not ridden every single one of them. Number 2, we have Helix at Leesburg. So now most of you know what number 1 is going to be. Helix has arguably the best variation of elements of any coasters in Europe. I mean, it has pretty much everything. Corkscrew, launches, other inversions, COG rolls, airtime hills, twists and turns. What does this coaster not have? And it does all it does really, really good. I can't wait to ride this coaster again. This couple of years back, I rode this last time. Was actually on the opening year, so it's 4 years ago. So I don't remember my experience as good as I do on some of the other rides on this list. But I do remember this was a really action-packed and really fun ride. Not just fun, but amazing. It also really really delivers strong airtime, which did surprise me. Yep, that's Vienna Felix. Of course, you all knew it, Canon still stays at my number one spot. So, I have a soft spot for this ride, because none of the other coasters on this list really came close to Canon. I'm not doubting a tiny bit about if this is my number one or not. The first butterfly lookalike element is amazing. You get some incredible airtime and you just eject down and it twists you, it gives you laterals and airtime at the same time. It has this dangle dive, it is so aggressive, so whippy. And it has two airtime hills, which is not the greatest part of the ride at all, but it is still amazing. Some of these turns pull some amazing G's. I forgot to mention the first drop is crazy. Maybe the best drop I've experienced. And all the stuff that happened inside the tower, which I'm not going to spoil, is also crazy. The theming is out of this world as well. Yeah, I just can't describe how much I love Canon. It might be a bit rattly, that's the only downside of this ride for me. But it is really really not too bad. Some people say it's really bad, I don't think it is that bad at all. Canon is amazing. Gotta love it. Thank you for watching my whole series for this year, my top 50. It has been a pleasure to make the list, so yeah, I also hope you had fun watching it. I will be back next year with my top 50 for 2019, which is, that'll go almost a year. So yeah, remember, none of the owner credit go to me. I've linked down in the description to the original videos what I use for the own rights of this video. So yeah, again, thank you for watching. Bye guys.